Well, it's been a tremendous year for us here on Raw. 2004 is a great year, and next week, our year-end special king, all the great main events from Monday Night Raw, pay-per-view main events, including the main event at WrestleMania, where Chris Benoit became the world heavyweight champ.
And you're going to see the main event from Survivor Series that led us up to all of this situation that's taking place tonight. And we're going to see Lita versus Trish and the whole Kane situation in Sinsky. It's going to be a very, very special show.
I'll tell you what, nothing really compares to the main event at WrestleMania, Shawn Michaels, Triple H, Chris Benoit for that world title. It's all here next week, right here on Monday Night Raw.
But now it's this week, and we are finally about to find out who is going to be the world heavyweight champion. Come on, JR, who do you think?
No more speculation. I've never been on the same wavelength with Eric Bischoff.
Well, I thought sure it was going to be Edge, but after that heartfelt plea, I think I saw tears in the eyes of Triple H. It's got to be the game.
I'm kind of inclined to agree with the fans, quite frankly. I'd like to see that rematch.
Who's going to be the world heavyweight champion? It's time to make that decision. I would like the three men who were involved in the controversial championship triple threat match to come down to the ring right now. Edge.
He's
Oh, try this earlier tonight. And all hell broke loose, King. Remember that?
Oh, yeah, well. Edge has a good argument, JR. And quite frankly, I'd like to see him champion. He's never even had a shot at being the world champion. What do you think? We can use some new fresh blood as the world
Chris
champion.
Chris Benoit.
I love Benoit, man. Here's your favorite. Go ahead. I thought Benoit made a great point earlier that the championship should be earned. That's why Benoit is one of the most respected men ever on Monday Night Raw, because he's earned everything he's ever gotten in life.
It's all about the game.
And Triple H.
It's all about control.
Dang, I can't believe that Triple H was actually begging Eric Bischoff to award the game the world's heavyweight title just before we went to that last commercial break.
You know what? I can't argue with you, JR. That's what he was doing. He was actually begging. He was pleading for his life, actually, because he said that the world championship is his life. And I can understand that, but dude, I think he's crying.
God, it's my friend who thinks that becoming a man that would be champion today.
Wait a minute. He said Eric Bischoff should do the right thing for business.
What is Evolution doing out here, by the way?
They're here to make sure what happened earlier doesn't take place again, I guess.
Triple H, I asked you to come down to the ring alone.
It's all right. It's okay, Eric. Evolution and I are one and the same. Evolution is a part of me. When Evolution succeeds, I succeed, and vice versa. It doesn't matter, Eric, whether it's Batista, whether it's the Nature Boy, or whether it's a game. Together, we have more wins than both of these guys combined, and above all else, Eric, the world heavyweight champion should be a winner. So, I just think the choice is pretty obvious for you, Eric.
Interesting. It's a different approach than the one you had in my office a few moments ago. But let's talk about my choices. My first choice tonight was Chris Benoit's option to have a rematch for the triple threat match tonight.
Well, that's what the fans want.
Well, I thought about that and I decided that that's just not what I wanted to do. Ooh. And then Edge gave me a choice. He wanted me to just hand the belt over. But you know what? From a purely business point of view, that would be just too risky, given that you've never held the title before. Which brings me to my third choice. Now, Triple H, you say that a win for Evolution is a win for you, right? Well, I'm going to put that theory to the test. On January 9th, 2005, we're going to have a pay-per-view called New Year's Revolution. And in New Year's Revolution, we're going to have a match that's a proven commodity. A match that will prove without a shadow of a doubt who deserves to be the world heavyweight champion. It's something that I like to call the Elimination Chamber.
Oh my God!
The world title will remain vacant until New Year's Revolution, when we have one of, if not the biggest championship matches in Raw's history. And it's going to feature Chris Benoit, Edge, Triple H. Y2J, Chris Jericho!
Chris Jericho? What?
And Evolution's own Batista!
What? Batista?
And last but not least, Randy Orton!
Oh, wait a minute! Orton back in the hunt! Can he do this? Why didn't he get him the general manager? But have you ever heard of such a thing, JR?
This is a done deal! Elimination Chamber, I cannot believe that! Look at this! Another combustible almost, and here we go again. Another fight is broken out. And I can't believe I'm in shock. The Elimination Chamber. I mean, that could be career suicide inside the Elimination Chamber.
It's going to feature these men and that man. Chris Jericho is going to be involved in it as well, and now he's entered the fray right here.
Jericho coming out to get some retribution from earlier tonight in the game. Going to back out of the fight. He's escaping.
I don't blame him.
He's ducking. Oh, my.
Good night. Randy, your back.
Randy Orton, the legend killer. Orton and Triple H will get back to the ring at the Elimination Chamber King. Who's going to become the world's champion? And look at this, Orton.
Get up.
Oh, Orton in the Elimination Chamber with a chance to become the world's heavyweight champion.
Come on, Gabe. We got a point to prove right here.
No, Orton with a reverse elbow knocking down Triple H. It is what an earth-shattering announcement.
No,
and we may see an earth-shattering RKO.
No, we don't need an RKO. No, not on Triple H.
Oh, Batista in. Evolution's animal. Henry.
Yeah!
RKO! Orton taking down the